In January 2012, hundreds of single people joined an ambitious experiment designed to find out if science can help you find love.
Are you ready to meet your match?
It began with Britain's biggest ever blind date.
How you doing? You alright?
Hey!
But these were no random introductions. Each couple was matched by experts who believe you'll be luckier in love if you take a scientific approach.
I'm in shock, like, how it works.
There's maybe a bit of chemistry, but there's nothing there, I'm sorry.
I'm happy. Please let him be happy too, or this is going to be brutal.
Don't want to be nasty, she's really nice. I'm not wowed.
Yeah, oh, my cat, I got the cream. So far, so good.
Well done, science.
So can love be created in a lab? The brains behind the experiment are Thomas Chamorro-Premusic and Emma Kenny. Thomas is a personality profiling expert.
Millions of people are single because they're hooked to this crazy idea that there's just one perfect person out there waiting for them. The reality is that we have several potential good matches, and compatibility tests will help them find them.
Emma is a behavioral psychologist.
We've designed this experiment to prove that science can help you find love, and that by carefully measuring compatibility, you're a lot more likely to find somebody who's just right for you.
Couples put together in the lab meet at the launch event, with more joining in the weeks that follow.
I'm impressed, so yeah. Hopefully you are too. I don't know what kind of girls you go for.
To us?
Definitely.
Cheers.
Each week, we'll follow a new set of couples who decide to see each other again.
He has suggested date two, which is really exciting.
I don't know if he's getting a kiss or not. Depends if he goes in for one.
Thomas and Emma will monitor their progress for up to a year.
I really fancy Rogan. I'm not gonna lie.
Well, let's say on a physical level, it's 100% working.
Absolutely.
It's going to be exciting to see how our couples get along, and no doubt there are going to be some surprises.
It'll be fascinating to see what happens next. All my research and the science suggests it should work, but in practice, we have no idea.
Whatever happens, we'll be there every step of the way. But will any of the couples even like each other?
First kiss? Oh, my God!
If I was a guy, I wouldn't do that as a date again.
Will any of them last the whole year?
I guess I was kind of expecting to hear from him maybe a bit more.
She seems to think I'm only after one thing.
I can't stop smiling, look.
And will the experts be proved right? Will anyone find love?
Okay, so will be my girlfriend.
What happens when you take hundreds of singletons and turn them into perfectly matched couples in a single day? Can science really help us find our perfect match? Welcome to the Year of Making Love. It's the start of our unique experiment. Single guys and girls from across the UK are descending on the launch centre. Each one of them has been selected by science as one half of a compatible pair. Right now, they have no idea who they've been matched with, so everyone's checking out the possibilities.
Brunette over there is amazing. If I get paired with her, I'll be a happy lad.
Good thing is they're all, like, really different.
As long as they're hot.
One in a purple dress, she is smoking.
There is a lot of fishy men in here.
So the launch centre is really starting to fill up, and the singles do look a little bit nervous. So down here is where everybody gets their unique number. And then the boys go over here, and the girls are in here, looking amazing.
Everyone here is out of luck when it comes to finding love.
I've been single for 3 years.
About 3 or 4 years now.
2.5 years.
7 months.
About 2 years.
I've been single since last 26 years.
With no hope on the horizon, can science help them find their soulmate?
I'm not sure that that poor girl that has her name written next to mine already somewhere on a piece of paper is necessarily, like, the one.
I think it can, because if you've got something in common with somebody, then that's a basis. That's a really strong basis to kind of make a relationship work. moment has finally come. Everyone's heading into the big event room to be matched up. So the couples are all here, they're sitting down, they are ready, they're chomping at the bit, and the air is thick with anticipation. And I cannot wait to see who is matched with who, but first, I'm just gonna have a little chat with the crowd. It's incredibly exciting that for each of you, somewhere in here is your chosen match. Okay, well, I think we should get the matchmaking machine up and running. Are you ready to meet your match?
Everyone's revved up and ready to go. Thomas and Emma will monitor each new pairing for signs of attraction.
What about this?
The first guy to take to the stage is Will, a student from Surrey.
My perfect woman, I believe, would be probably blonde. Quite glamorous, maybe quite good-looking, friendly, fun, something like that, really. It'd be kind of quite awkward if she was completely the opposite of what I'm expecting, but I have to wait and see. No idea. I have no idea what to expect.
Like everyone today, Will won't know who he's been paired with until he meets her on stage.
More nervous now than excited. I have no idea what to expect. I just hope she likes Rose. I hope she appreciates it.
Couple one.
Science says Will's perfect match is Kay from Essex.
Nice to see you. How you doing?
Nice to see you.
What's your name?
That's a really charming little match there, isn't it?
I'm sorry. Can't really remember a great deal. It went past so fast. I think she liked my rose, which is good. It went down well.
He seems like a good-looking boy. Got me a rose, which is really sweet.
Are you nervous?
Yeah, can you tell? Do I fancy him? Maybe.
I can't believe we went first.
I know, I'm sitting in my heart. It's racist. She's not the normal type of girl I'd go for. But then I'm gonna, you know, have an open mind and see how it goes.
I don't know his personality yet, so that's a big thing. So I'm looking forward to finding out what he's like.
Will and Kay now have time to chat before they decide if they want to see each other again. Back in the matchmaking room, new couples are being created thick and fast. It's the first step in this year-long experiment. And while some couples look less than happy with their match...
This is terrible, look.
That's not going to work. I don't know what to say. Not quite what I was expecting, though.
Others seem to hit it off immediately.
Wow. So they saw each other and immediately hugged, and they got a standing ovation. There's a really good atmosphere here today. Everyone's kind of rooting for the couples.
What's your name?
Josie.
She's lovely, she's a really nice girl. Initially, everything's really cool.
I'm definitely looking forward to getting to know him a bit better, and yeah, maybe we'll take it further.
Milky.
Okay.
Meanwhile, our first couple, Will and Kay, have been discovering they have a lot in common.
Really? Wow.
Oh, no.
Oh my God.
How close do we live to each
Very
other?
Very close. We're literally about, I'd say, less than half a mile. Oh my God. Kay is a nice girl and we have quite similar interests, so obviously the whole science behind of it does make sense.
Really friendly, chatty guy, which is good. We've got, creepily, quite a lot in common. I have no idea who fancies me or not. We'll have to wait and see, I guess.
I wouldn't say I fancied her yet. One thing that's clouding my judgment at the moment is that I've seen another girl sitting quite close to our table that I do find attractive and probably is more my normal type. But then she's matched with someone else, so I can't obviously go and talk to her.
And Will's not the only one getting distracted by the ladies.
Stranger, yeah.
Checking out another girl.
Thanks for that.
If the boys don't focus on the girl they've been paired with, they'll never find out why they've been matched. Let's hope the next guy looking for love gives science a chance.
A bit nervous, but expected, optimistic.
Like I said, not going to lie, if she's not very good looking, I would be pretty disappointed as well.
22-year-old Rogan is a model and a club promoter. He's young, but keen to settle down.
I have been single for 2 years now. I have kind of been looking for love. I kind of got fed up with just seeing girls and just kind of one-night stands and things like that, so decided I want to look for something a bit more serious.
When Rogan's not pumping iron, he's out on the town.
He's a bit of a party boy, so I think what he needs is a girl that can match him and can keep up with him on the social side of it. That might slow him down a bit.
I think there may be a perfect person out there for me. I haven't found them yet, but yeah, I'm willing to keep looking and trying.
Both scoring high on sociability, Rogan's been paired with 29-year-old Natalie, a shop manager from Guildford.
These two look...
Yeah, good.
..happy with the fact that they've been matched.
Yeah.
And the fact that Natalie's 7 years older doesn't seem to matter.
He is a hottie, you know. I'm kind of hoping that he finds me a little bit attractive, and a little bit will be fine.
Hello.
Help me out.
No, it's worth the wait, definitely.
We'll see.
As the day continues, new couples are created by the minute.
What's your name, Sol?
Ruth.
Sam. Yeah.
And many of the guys are out to impress. From the smoothest of operators.
Hello.
Shut up.
Yeah, he's really good looking. Good budget.
To some real-life Romeos.
He seems really friendly, really charming. He bought me some flowers. I mean, what more can a girl ask for?
I bet you a cocktail.
Let's hope our next girl searching for a soulmate is happy with her match.
My name is Danny. I'm 21 and I live in North London. I definitely move in love, 100%. I just haven't been successful in picking the right person. It's quite depressing, actually. I wouldn't say that she's necessarily unlucky in love. She'll always sort of find something that be like, oh, no, maybe it isn't right because of this, because she doesn't want to get let down. I don't think I've found my perfect match because I don't think many guys can, like, keep up with me. Like, I'm quite wild. I go out looking quite classy and not... I don't go out with these little skirts or anything like that. Do I look like Camel? My perfect guy, who'd have like a cheeky tan. I love a bit of tan going on. Like, there's nothing worse than someone being quite pale.
He's got a cheeky tan. He told me he's just had a sunburn.
I think the science can find me the perfect partner because they're scientists, right? They can find out anything. Like, this could be the turning point in my love life. I hope so. Like, I'm quite excited about it.
I'm sexy and I know it.
Danny's match is club promoter Ellis from Kent.
Hiya. You got honey?
Hiya. What do you think?
I like it. They may just work.
Bit of fake tan on the go?
No, something, that's it.
He is everything I fancy. As soon as I see him, I said fake tan. How old are you, babe?
19.
Oh, yeah, you look older than that.
Yeah, just good laugh, really. And she's good looking, so. Yeah, big package, so it's all good.
Oh, science is bang on, but boy, I'm loving him. He's up to scratch big time.
Sexy and I know it.
I've got this thing about hygiene, like guys with dirty fingernails or anything like that. Let's see yours.
Oh, no.
No, yours are sweet as. He's definitely tickling my fancy all day long.
Danny's like the female version of me. Same likes, same dislikes.
You better take my number.
Yeah. I'm going to call you Danny True Love.
Yeah, that'd be nice.
It looks like Danny's found the man she's been looking for. But will our next guy enjoy as much success?
I'm Andrew Cove. I'm from Coventry. Just looking for a bit of love, really.
22-year-old Andy is a personal trainer and fitness fanatic. He might look the hard man, but inside, he's a real softie.
I'd consider myself a bit of a romantic. I believe that you can just fall for someone and you could be with people forever. That and my grandma and granddad met. They seen each other at a dance. fell in love. My granddad asked my grandma to dance with her and they fell in love and stayed together for the rest of their lives. I haven't found my perfect partner yet because I think I've got need time to mature and stuff, and I've not met the right girl that has made me want to mature. If science does work, then I don't know where it will lead. I'll just let love blossom.
Both scoring high on loyalty, Andy has been paired with Kirsty, a student from Birmingham.
This is a good one.
Yeah, that's
this
a good match. Good
one. Very strong.
He's happy, she's happy.
Yeah.
Totally staying together.
Absolutely stunning girl. When I first saw her, I'll give her a bit of a twirl on the stage. I got a few laughs.
When I saw him, I was quite pleasantly surprised, actually. He seems like a really nice guy. He's really funny. Oh, my God.
She's really funny, bubbly. Everything I was looking for, really, so looks like it's been a pretty good match.
After a day of solid matchmaking, our epic launch event is coming to an end. Hundreds of single people put their faith in a scientific formula. And as the day draws to a close, a final few promising pairings are made.
Hello, beautiful.
Hello.
You look incredible. Want to piggyback?
Yeah, I'm going to
piggyback. Oh, my God. There's our marriage. There's our marriage.
Hundreds of introductions have been made, and this extraordinary year-long experiment is well and truly up and running.
So, it's up to the couples now.
Absolutely, you know, our job is virtually done. And now it's up to them, but I mean, we work hard to make their life easier and their journey more enjoyable and successful. So hopefully, you know, it will work.
There's something now fantastic for us, which is we're going to sit back, we're going to watch the experiment take place, and we're going to observe these people, hopefully, in some cases, going through the motions of falling in love, and indeed falling out of love.
When I see you, I thought, oh my God, like, actual science is real. Like, you're nearly as pretty as me.
Yeah, I'll say we're going to see each other again.
Would you?
Oh, thanks. We're probably not.
First date went pretty well, quite compatible.
No, it went well. The first date went well. It's good.
I think we're going to see each other again.
Yes.
We've swapped numbers, and Faisal's asked me out for dinner.
Just one dinner, and then after that, nothing else.
Joke. I want to take her home now, but she's not that kind of girl.
He actually has suggested this. No is the answer to that one. We're going to do this properly. There we go. That's it. Got lipstick on him now.
Oh, yep. Yeah.
There it is.
It's been 2 weeks since the launch of the experiment. Tonight, Natalie is getting ready for a date with Rogan.
I'm less nervous now. I'm actually getting quite excited again, which is a nice feeling, because I hate being nervous. I don't know whether to give him a kiss on the cheek or just to hug him or...
29-year-old shop manager Natalie has been single for the last 4 years.
I believe that there is the perfect match out there for me. It's just taken me a very long time to find that person or for that person to come and find me.
She's not short of admirers, but Natalie hasn't found the one.
I'm not sure what it is, you know. Her relationships have been very short-term lately. When she lets her hair down, she goes a bit wild, maybe a bit too wild, but, you know, maybe that makes people go, oof.
My last proper boyfriend, he was younger than me. That didn't work out because he thought I wanted to obviously do the whole let's get married kind of thing, and he wasn't ready for that. I didn't want that, but he just thought that because I was older. I've also seen guys who are 10 years older than me. It was weird because they didn't know what they wanted. I want to live life and enjoy it, and just hopefully someone can share that with me and we'll just go on the journey together. Simple. That's all I want.
Natalie's been invited to Rogan's place. A 2-hour drive away, she's been offered a bed for the night. But Natalie's determined to take things slow.
My pyjamas and a proper top. Rogan may think that something's going to come out of staying at his house, but I know that that is not going to happen. There's no skin going to be shown, no. If it's all about sex for him, wrong person, I'm afraid. He needs to find somebody else because I'm not that person.
Having suffered heartbreak in the past, Natalie's hoping Rogan will be different.
We are in Rogan land. We are near his home. And I've suddenly started to feel really, 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 really nervous. Right, that's it.
Hello.
You're right. Hello, how are you?
Okay.
Are you good?
Yeah, I'm good. How are you?
Nice to see you.
You too. Do you want to say that?
Oh, thanks.
You're welcome.
Rogan's got some people he'd like Natalie to meet.
Hi.
His mum and dad.
I'm Natalie. Nice to meet you both. How are you? You all right?
Yeah,
not too bad, thank you. Not too bad.
It's a long journey.
Couple of hours, but it was fine. Not too bad.
The meeting with her is just that they obviously seem really, really, really lovely. That was just really weird. I felt a bit awkward. So now I just wanted to, I don't know. I just hope they don't think I'm odd.
Rogan's taking the sofa tonight so Natalie can have his room.
I did a little bit of tidying for the first time in a long time.
Oh, really?
Especially.
No, like, naked photos of girls, no porn anywhere?
Well,
to, like, come across it.
I hit it all, so you're all right.
Right.
But yeah, and I'll just be sleeping downstairs, probably.
Definitely.
Natalie and Rogan escape the watchful eye of mum and dad.
Cheers. It's their first date.
First date.
It's their first chance to really get to know each other.
Right, I'm going in with the fingers.
I just want to tuck into the ribs, but...
Do it!
Stuff's going to get messy.
Just take it. First date so far is actually going really well. Well, I think it is, anyway. We're just starting to get a bit more comfortable with each other now. Just looked at me and licked your lip.
I was licking some sweet chilli off my lip. I didn't know you were going to look up at the same time. Yeah, it's going good. Getting on really well. Had some nice drinks, nice food. Getting a bit of banter going with Natalie, which is always good.
Send me some kind of...
The attraction's there, but Natalie wants to know if the age gap is an issue.
So the fact that I'm pushing on 30,
yeah,
that doesn't bother you at all in the slightest.
Well, it doesn't bother me, man.
That's totally the opposite of what I thought. I convinced myself that you weren't looking for a relationship, that
why are you here?
You were some player.
Why are you here then?
Because I wanted to find out for myself.
Okay, good.
It could have gone either way.
Well, hopefully you found out now, because. I'm not some sort of player. I'm just looking for a nice girl.
Genuinely?
Genuinely. So, yeah. Serious questions got, like, a bit deep for me for a first date. She seems to think I'm only after one thing, apparently, which isn't the case at all. I really like her, so we'll just see. Got to try and convince her otherwise.
I did get a bit deep in the conversation, but to be fair, I did have a few concerns, and obviously he was able to answer them.
Thank you.
Yeah, possibly exciting times to come for Natalie and Rogan, perhaps, maybe, hopefully.
With mum and dad asleep upstairs, Natalie and Rogan take the opportunity to have one last nightcap.
Okay, Natalie. We're back to my house after we went for a nice date.
Yes.
How are you feeling?
Well, I really fancy Rogan. I'm not gonna lie.
That's a given.
I've had more rosé. He's had more vodka.
Yeah.
And I'm starting to feel the effects of it. But remember what I said. I am not sleeping with Rogan on the first date.
A It's the morning after the night before. And Rogan's not on the sofa.
Getting in the shower.
I'm not going to lie, I don't know really kind of the extent of what happened. We came back here, had some more drink, had a bit of a chat. Perhaps something more happened. Don't know.
Wine left if you want.
Shut
up. Bedroom plans might have gone out the window. Yeah, we ended up sharing a bed. Thank.
Worried about what Rogan's thinking, Natalie wants to clear the air.
In all honesty, obviously I didn't want that, like, didn't want that to happen.
Yeah.
But I think whatever was going on, we were quite comfortable with each other.
Yeah.
So, you know, you sleeping in the same bed as me, it was whatever. Maybe it felt quite natural, so it's not a problem.
Yeah.
But I just hope that your perception of me hasn't changed, like I'm that girl, because, you know, I'd like to think that that's not the sort of be-all and end-all kind of thing.
Yeah.
So as long as you don't think I'm that, you know, some kind of floozy.
I know you're not like that.
There you go. So it's cool.
Mm-hmm.
That's fine. And nothing's changed.
Yeah.
So that's awesome.
Yeah.
Wicked.
Good.
Before saying their goodbyes, Rogan's treating Natalie to a slap-up breakfast.
To the sandwich van.
Served up at his mum and dad's food van.
It's going to be quite peculiar, especially because they're going to obviously ask us how it went last night. But I'm not going to, like, divulge details that they really don't need to know, because I don't want them to think that I corrupted their son. How are you? You all right?
Yeah, good, thanks.
Fine, thank you.
Good time last night?
It was lovely.
Yeah,
thank
it was
you.
Great. Thanks.
Brown sandwich.
That's
yeah,
all.
It's me. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
She seems a really sweet girl.
Yeah, it's very difficult. We've only just met her, but she seems lovely, very natural, and good sense of humour.
She'd have to have a good sense of humour, really, to be going out of a robot.
It's very nice.
So. When you come, you're obviously going to come down to me next time.
Yeah, I'm working every night next week. First date with Natalie overall went really well. We had a laugh, it was good banter, just felt really comfortable. Yeah, it felt like we've been seeing each other for a long time, so yeah, it was cool.
So my first date with Rogan has gone really, 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 really well. Yeah, I really like him, and his mum and dad seem really nice as well, and hopefully I've made a good impression on them. We're going to meet up, I think, in like couple of weeks time. I kind of wish it was a bit sooner, but that's fine, I can wait.
At the launch of the experiment, Andy from Nuneaton was matched with Kirsty from Stourport. And it looked like the experts had paired them well.
Yeah, that's a good match. That is a good match. When I saw him, I was quite pleasantly surprised, actually. He seems like a really nice guy. He's really funny.
Looked into your eyes and thought, beautiful.
Yeah, I'd say we're going to see each other again.
Would you?
Oh, thanks. We're probably not.
A few weeks later, and Kirsty and Andy's relationship has been moving forward at lightning speed. They've seen each other non-stop and have racked up a whopping £120 of phone bill each.
Since we've been matched, it's actually been moving quite fast. We've been speaking loads. I think we speak every day.
22-year-old student Kirsty has been out of luck when it comes to finding love.
I do believe in love. I like the idea of it, but I haven't found it yet, so maybe I'll just hit me.
The boys on campus have failed to make the grade.
in previous relationships, I sort of feel like I wasn't treated the way I should be treated.
Student nights out have been non-stop fun for Kirsty, but they're not helping her find a man.
After a drink, I think I'm really annoying, and if a guy meets me and I've had a drink, I think he would be put off straight away.
Love! I want to find love! I want to find someone that I love!
Today, Kirsty's booked a session at an outdoor activity centre, and despite it being early days, she's invited her parents along to meet Andy, hoping for their seal of approval.
What's the situation you've told your mum and dad, like, if you said we're acquaintances or...?
No, I said that, seeing a guy.
Some guy?
Yeah.
He's all right. He's average.
No, I said that I like you, but I haven't said that we're going out or anything. I'm really nervous about meeting my parents. I think I like him a lot. I'm scared if they'll judge him or not.
I've heard the parents are really nice people, so I'm not worried about that sort of thing because I get on with most people anyway.
Turns out Andy's not just meeting mum and dad.
We've just got here. Where are you? Oh, there. Grand and granddad are here as well.
Oh my God!
Wow. No pressure on Andy.
How's it going?
What's your daddy, Kirsty? What's
your daddy? It's Andy! I'm Roy. It's my dad.
How
you going? Nice to meet you. You're all right.
It's my nan.
Hello.
Granny Bean.
Nice to meet you.
It's my mum.
You're all right.
It's my granddad.
You're all right. Awesome.
Yeah.
I just met the parents. They're really nice. Didn't need to be nervous, really. Said hello and stuff. So, yeah, it's fine.
Chuggy! Yeah. I was a bit nervous when Andy meeting my parents, but I feel fine like now that I spoke. He's like really like natural with him, fine.
So are either of you scared of heights at all?
Yeah.
That's the worst bit, I think. I feel running! So cocky. And me, like, trembling. My parents are following us, like, the whole thing, taking photos and videos. It looks really easy, but it's not.
It's hard.
Especially when you're not, when you can't look down.
I think he seems a really nice guy, natural, caring, catches her when she's jumping off the platforms.
Seems to be all right, yeah. Yeah, you seem fine.
It's early days, but Kirsty and Andy do seem to have something.
She's an amazing girl. Never met anyone like her. I hope she'll say the same about me.
He could be a keeper. He's got potential. Yeah, he's got potential to be a keeper.
Something special there. Definitely.
It's been a month since Kirsty and Andy met at the launch of the experiment, and their relationship continues to move at pace. Andy's just moved into his own flat, partly to be closer to Kirsty.
So this is me, my new flat. So, yeah, gonna see how I get on. There's some opportunities come up, so I thought I'd take them. Kirsty was a little part of that.
Although she likes him a lot, Kirsty's wondering whether they should slow things down.
I sometimes feel that Andrew's a bit, not keen, but he's the one always talking about, like, where it's going, where are we and stuff, which I like, because I wouldn't ever, like, say anything like that, but it just scares me a little bit. I haven't been in a relationship for, like, a year and a half.
But ever the romantic, Andy's planned a three-course meal at his new flat.
I do feel like I'm a bit of a romantic. I think it's just a bit dead and buried nowadays, and I think if you show a bit of romance to someone, it goes a long way. It's just a little effort that makes a girl go, "Oh."
He's even penned her a poem.
Bit of a funny story, how I first met you. Walked across the stage, eyes beautifully blue. But what I've learned and what I appreciate late at night It's how you've shown me the way of what perfect looks like.
But will Andy's efforts actually scare Kirsty off?
A bit nervous not going in. Don't know why. Hello. Surprise!
I've got all the starter out already.
Oh! Oh, I need a candle! Is this naan bread?
Yeah.
Do you have naan bread and hummus? Are you meant to have pita bread and hummus?
You did smell what? We're on the start of
our curry, was it? Got four,
two courses left yet.
The presentation was really nice. Got all the cutlery out, all like posh. Thank you. £3. He puts like loads of effort into things. It's really sweet. That sort of thing with like my exes, I didn't like do like special random like things.
Here's the main.
It's like a restaurant.
Of course it is.
But I don't think microwave rice in a restaurant.
Am I doing good?
Yeah. I'm a bit scared to like take like make it really like committed, like be girlfriend and boyfriend, and it's really scary for me.
So, what will Kirsty make of Andy's poem?
Oh, you're so cute. The poem makes me feel like I do really like him. I've got to stop myself from liking him too much too soon. So, being a bit breezy about it. Bye.
The launch of this ambitious relationship experiment, hundreds of people met their scientific match on stage.
Hiya!
How are you doing? You alright?
Yeah, yeah.
Lovely to meet you.
But in the following days, many decided they were better off single. Will and Kay were the first match to be made.
He seems like a good-looking boy. Got me a rose, which is really sweet.
And the first couple to drop out of the experiment.
I've seen another girl sitting quite close to our table. I do find attractive.
We both took each other's numbers, but I don't think either of us had the intention of really talking to each other afterwards.
Danny and Ellis were delighted with each other on the day.
Hiya. Danny's like the female version of me.
He's definitely tickling my fancy all day long.
Which makes it all the more surprising Ellis never called her. When Faisal met Josie, they agreed to go on a date.
I think we're going to see each other again.
Yeah. Okay. My first thoughts when I saw Josie were hips and legs and bum.
They arranged to meet for dinner, but Josie started having doubts.
I'm just dreading the conversation tonight because I don't think we're going to have anything to talk about.
And at the very last moment, she ditched the date altogether.
I don't think I'm going to go. I just don't think I can put myself through it.
Yeah, I got stood up. I'm not hurt, pissed.
One night of sin. In Guildford, it's been weeks since Natalie shared a bed with Rogan, and she hasn't heard from him since.
I've been a bit crappy. Because I guess I was kind of expecting to hear from him, I guess. It kind of feels like he's not actually that interested.
She's hoping her older brother, Robert, can offer some sound advice.
Do you want anything else, Nats?
No, thanks.
So what's this guy's name?
He's called Rogan.
Uh-huh.
And he's 22. He's
22? Okay. All right.
But he's cool.
Okay, so when you have met up...
The once.
What was it like? How was the, you know, was it
was it was good. No, it was fun. I thought we got on really well.
Uh-huh. And so after the next day, who contacted... So you said he contacted you?
No, I contacted him.
Right, okay. And how did that conversation go?
It was a text message. I didn't hear from him for a while.
Right, OK. I'm not getting good vibes about it, to be honest. I think anybody would probably say the same thing. If you weren't you, and you're having this conversation with somebody else, well, what advice would you give them?
He's probably not interested. Let it go. It's probably what I'd say.
That would be your point. That would be your your initial response.
Yeah, but for some reason, I'm holding out.
Okay. As long as you're happy. You've got to do what you're happy with.
Natalie decides to keep waiting for Rogan to get in touch. Over in the Midlands, Kirsty and Andy's relationship is going from strength to strength.
Yo.
Nice to see you, pal.
You're
up, mate. Missed you.
Andy's back at his mum and dad's house, where he lived before he moved to be closer to Kirsty.
I miss him all the time. He was always my best friend, and he was like my right arm that's gone.
And that's around Kirsty's house.
Andy lets his family know how the relationship is going.
She looks absolutely stunning, the sort of girl that he would go for, because, you know, he's a good-looking lad, my son.
Are you really into her?
Yeah, I am.
Oh.
Well, I could call that.
Is it Liv?
Tomorrow, Andy's taking Kirsty to Amsterdam, where he plans to take their relationship to the next level.
I'm going to ask her out when we get there.
Oh, yeah. Make
find,
it official.
Find a nice little spot and
yeah,
make it all nice. Ask her out.
I think Andrew is a bit of a romantic. I'm not quite sure where he's got that from.
Well, you only have to look as far as me. It's taught him all he knows.
He told me he put flowers on Kirsty's bed. You've never, ever bought me a bunch of flowers ever in 25 years.
I did, anniversary, I sent them to your work.
One.
Ah!
Into their relationship, this is their first trip away together, and Kirsty has no idea what Andy's got up his sleeve.
How beautiful she is. You're beautiful, eh, babe?
Yo, we're in Amsterdam, the place to be. Makes it better because I'm with Kirsty. She never seen.
Finally, Andy finds the perfect moment to say his piece.
Here's this. I've got something to tell you.
I'm really happy over the past month. And, what you so much. Never felt this way before about anyone. How do you feel about making it official and being my girlfriend?
I'd love to, babe.
You'd love to.
In Amsterdam.
How you feeling?
Happy.
Happy?
Yeah.
It's made me a really happy guy.
It's like getting married or something.
Back with Natalie and Rogan, after weeks of hearing nothing, and just when Natalie was about to give up all hope, Rogan's got back in touch.
Recently, I've been really, really busy. And I've been away working, hosting in some clubs in Portugal for the past week, so I've just got back. Now back in the gym, back to doing a bit of work, but more importantly, back to talking to Natalie again.
But after all that happened on their first date, it's been a difficult time for Natalie.
For me, you know, not hearing from him, you know, and feeling like he was being quite cold, it was horrible. Not only was I questioning if he liked me, if he was interested, I was just genuinely questioning myself. Way too much happened for a first date. Why did I go against everything that I had said I wasn't going to do? Why did I go and do that?
It didn't make me think differently or any less of it or anything like that, that we hit it off so well. I just thought that it just happened and, yeah, felt right, so it was fine.
Do I think he's a pretty boy player? Do you know what? No. I think I'm going to give him the benefit of the doubt.
months after their first meeting, Natalie's decided to meet Rogan on neutral ground. She's hoping to find out once and for all if he's the right man for her.
I think deep down, as much as my guard is up, I guess I'm hoping that he will give me a chance.
Hello.
Hello.
Brave at them shots, how you doing?
How are you? You're right.
Yeah, good.
Good to see you.
You too.
You good?
Yeah, you?
Yeah, not too bad.
Very nice.
Long time. No, no see. Do you want to get under?
Yeah, yeah.
Sorry, it's a bit wet.
I haven't been to a theme park before.
You've never been here?
Nah.
Dude.
Never been
it's
anywhere.
It's like fun times. This is going to be fun. That is the best bit. That bit right there.
I was wondering whether, when I saw her, we'd have the same attraction, same kind of chemistry as we did when we first met, and, yeah, the attraction's definitely still there.
That is classic. Look at your face. We're just having a giggle, like I wanted to have, which is awesome, so I'm happy, it's cool, it's good. So, have you, like, enjoyed today?
Yeah, I
here
have.
And...
Yeah, it has been nice to see you.
Well, it's been good to, you know, catch up with you, sort of, you know, see each other in this kind of environment, you know.
Reignite the flame.
Reignite, yeah, there you go. Yes.
Yeah. Okay, cool.
That's one way of putting it.
Today's been really good. It's been really nice to see Natalie, spend some time with her. Yeah, the attraction's definitely still there with Natalie. I said to her, when we spoke at first, she was worried it might be a bit awkward or whatever, but I wasn't really. I just thought because we got on so well the first time, we will this time, and we have, so yeah, it's been good to catch up.
Today has been really, really fun. You know, as much as I do fancy him, be cool. If he's interested, obviously he'll need to show me in some way, shape or form, and we'll just try, you know, if anything develops, it will develop naturally.
Perhaps things will take off second time around. Meanwhile, Kirsty and Andy are making the most of their first summer as an official item.
What are we doing now, beautiful?
From updating their relationship status...
Just changing it to in a relationship with Miss Your Coo.
..to rooftop barbecues.
Steak as tender as can be.
Throwing a party for all their friends, it's obvious to everyone how close they have become.
I don't talk about Kirsty much, do I?
This is Kirsty's dream, we talk about her all the time.
No, I don't!
Definitely do.
I think that Kirsty and Andy are just definitely meant to be, like, just together, they just work.
Andrew's got more romantic, I'd even say pathetic, because he's writing poems and telling me about them every day.
I have never liked him so
play?
Much, I wrote him a poem.
You can tell that there's only one guy for her now, and that is Andy.
As well as their mates, Kirsty and Andy are also spending more time with each other's families. Today, Andy's been invited to the Stourport Mayor's annual charity ball. It's a chance for some quality time with Kirsty's dad.
Yeah. I've never done this sort of thing before, so I'm quite worried about it. A bit nervous.
He's looking good, he's looking good, looking smart.
I do feel good, like, just sitting in it.
Looking smart for my girl. It needs to look smart for her, then.
Hello, you're right. How's it going?
Welcome.
Hello.
Kirsty is Stourport's carnival queen and the mayor's guest of honour at
Thank
the
you
bash.
Very much. He's a lucky guy, isn't he?
Yeah.
He's a lucky guy. You want to get the respect same as you do.
This ain't what the sort of thing I'm used to, but I'm trying to handle it as best I can. It's not the sort of thing I normally do, but if that's what Kirsty does, then I'll follow her.
Andy's in unfamiliar territory, and he's forgotten to bring any cash.
£26 He's paying. I've got a card.
We don't take card, I'm afraid.
I'm bailing out again already.
How are you enjoying tonight?
Yeah, it's good.
You look a bit awkward.
Your dad's giving me loads of banter. I find it hard to deal with.
Why?
I don't know. He keeps on bringing money off number.
He always will.
Oh, no.
If he teases you, it means he likes you.
You said that.
I know.
He's all right, yeah.
Determined to pay his own way, Andy borrows some cash and wipes the slate clean.
Hey, well, there's 14. Just call it that.
Can I give you 30?
No, it's all right. I've not got anything here anyway. It's all right. Okay. Just get yourself a drink and beer.
Finally, Andy can relax.
I like doing this sort of thing. It's good, isn't it?
Yeah, we should
do
it more often.
Yeah. Just crash loads of balls across the country.
That'd be amazing.
We love our balls.
So who are you with? The mayor. There must be a mayor somewhere.
Who's going to every mayor? You got any balls coming up?
I don't know. Oh.
Keep saying balls a bit too much.
Yeah. Chill. Sour just like chill.
Natalie and Rogan seem to be back on course after their date at the theme park.
That is classic.
But history has repeated itself.
Okay, at this stage, I guess I've got a bit of a confession to make as well. He said he wanted to see me. So I went. You can probably guess what happened.
Natalie shared a bed with Rogan for a second time, and once again, she's not heard from him since.
That gives me all the answers that I need. Really? I think, for the sake of my sanity, I can't. I don't think it's a good idea for me to continue being involved in this.
Couldn't be more different in Birmingham, where Andy's been planning a surprise weekend away with Kirsty. He's hoping that a trip to Newquay will be the perfect place to reveal that he's fallen in love.
It's going to be a really romantic weekend. I'm hoping for like a really special moment where I could just proper like go for it and look into each other's eyes and just say I love you and stuff. And I just want this to be like one of the moments where you just completely in awe of each other.
To kickstart the weekend in style, Andy's booked a top-notch hotel room.
Oh!
Wow.
Oh, I see the sea. It's all surfers.
You like it then?
So nice, isn't it? Our room's got a sea view, it's got big bay windows. Beautiful. The thoughts that he's done everything and it's so nice. I caught
the sun on my way home. Andy's surprise trip seems to be having the desired effect. Could this be the perfect moment for him to tell Kirsty how he feels?
See the sunset.
Oh.
How nice is that? Right, am I racing you down?
Really? Really? Really?
No, I don't.
Can I first start?
I took my shoes off. Wait, I've got rolls. Oh, it's so tricky! Oh, Kirsty. All this just made me realise how much I love you. I'm in love with you. I fell for you straight away. You're an absolutely amazing girl. Proper love you.
He told me he loved me. He's amazing. He's done all these things. He thought of all this today. He's well special.
I wanted to make sure, like, I tell her when I love her, it's in the moment and it's right. I belong, you belong
to me, my sweetheart. Complete strangers at the start of the year, it's a life-changing moment for Kirsty and Andy.
I literally fell for her the day I met her. It's crazy. And totally in love with her now.
It's so strange thinking that science put us together. I wasn't expecting it at all to actually match someone that I'd really like. And as if, like, this is happening now, it's unreal. It's crazy.
It's just amazing that it's all happened and I fell in love.
Are you in love?
Yeah.
It's an incredible moment for two people put together by science. Next time, we follow more couples in the Year of Making Love experiment.
I think I might, yeah, make a move tonight.
He's ridiculously what I go for.
I'm like the cat who got the cream.
Disgusting.
I am shitting myself a little bit.
Give it all
there.
Serious?
Give it all there.
And we've got more hormones tomorrow night on 3 as the new series of Sun Sex and Suspicious Parents hit Xanti. But up next, how Mr. T has time to pity stuff when he's being this hilarious is a mystery. It's new World's Craziest Fools.
In January 2012, hundreds of single people joined an ambitious experiment designed to find out if science can help you find love.
Are you ready to meet your match?
It began with Britain's biggest ever blind date.
How are you doing? You're right. Hey.
How are you doing?
But these were no random introductions. Each couple was matched by experts who believe you'll be luckier in love if you take a scientific approach.
I'm in shock, like, how it's worked.
There's maybe a bit of chemistry, but there's nothing there, I'm sorry.
I'm happy. Please let him be happy too, or this is going to be brutal.
I don't want to be nasty, she's really nice. I'm not wowed.
Yeah. Oh, my cat, I got the cream. So far, so good.
Well done, science.
So can love be created in a lab? The brains behind the experiment are Thomas Chamorro Premusic and Emma Kenny. Thomas is a personality profiling expert.
Millions of people are single because they're hooked to this crazy idea that there's just one perfect person out there waiting for them. The reality is that we have several potential good matches, and compatibility tests will help them find them.
Emma is a behavioural psychologist.
We've designed this experiment to prove that science can help you find love, and that by carefully measuring compatibility, you're a lot more likely to find somebody who's just right for you.
Couples put together in the lab meet at the launch event. With more joining in the weeks that follow.
I'm impressed, so yeah. Hopefully you are too. I don't know what kind of girls you go for.
To us.
Definitely.
Cheers.
Each week, we'll follow a new set of couples who decide to see each other again.
He has suggested date 2, which is really exciting.
I don't know if he's getting a kiss or not. Depends if he goes in for one.
Thomas and Emma will monitor their progress for up to a year.
I really fancy Rogan, I'm not gonna lie.
Well, let's say on a physical level, it's 100% working.
Absolutely.
It's going to be exciting to see how our couples get along, and no doubt there are going to be some surprises.
It'll be fascinating to see what happens next. All my research and the science suggests it should work, but in practice, we have no idea.
Whatever happens, we'll be there every step of the way. But will any of the couples even like each other?
First kiss? Oh, my God! If I was a guy, I wouldn't do that as a date again.
Will any of them last the whole year?
I guess I was kind of expecting to hear from him
maybe a bit more.
She seems to think I'm only after one thing.
I can't stop smiling, look.
And will the experts be proved right? Will anyone find love?
Okay, Kirsty will be my girlfriend.
What happens when you take hundreds of singletons and turn them into perfectly matched couples in a single day? Can science really help us find our perfect match? Welcome to the Year of Making Love.
It's the start of our unique experiment. Single guys and girls from across the UK are descending on the launch centre. Each one of them has been selected by science as one half of a compatible pair. Right now, they have no idea who they've been matched with, so everyone's checking out the possibilities.
Brunette over there is amazing. If I get paired with her, I'll be a happy lad.
Good thing is they're all, like, really different.
As long as they're hot.
One in a purple dress, she is smoking.
There is a lot of fishy men in here.
So the launch centre is really starting to fill up and the singles do look a little bit nervous. So down here is where everybody gets their unique number. And then the boys go over here and the girls,
the shorter one was there,
are in here looking amazing.
Everyone here is out of luck when it comes to finding love.
I've been single for 3 years.
About 3 or 4 years now.
2.5 years.
7 months.
About 2 years.
I've been single since last 26 years.
With no hope on the horizon, can science help them find their soulmate?
I'm not sure that that poor girl that has her name written next to mine already somewhere on a piece of paper is necessarily like the one.
I think it can, because if you've got something in common with somebody, then that's a basis. That's a really strong basis to kind of make a relationship work.
So the moment has finally come. Everyone's heading into the big event room to be matched up. So the couples are all here, they're sitting down, they are ready, they're chomping at the bit, and the air is thick with anticipation. And I cannot wait to see who is matched with who, but first, I'm just going to have a little chat with the crowd. Hello, everyone. It's incredibly exciting that for each of you, somewhere in here is your chosen match. OK, well, I think we should get the matchmaking machine up and running. Are you ready to meet your match?
Everyone's revved up and ready to go. Thomas and Emma will monitor each new pairing for signs of attraction.
What about this?
The first guy to take to the stage is Will, a student from Surrey.
My perfect woman, I believe, would be probably blonde. Quite glamorous, maybe quite good-looking, friendly, fun, something like that, really. It'd be kind of quite awkward if she was completely the opposite of what I'm expecting, but I have to wait and see. No idea. I have no idea what to expect.
Like everyone today, Will won't know who he's been paired with until he meets her on stage.
More nervous now than excited. I have no idea what to expect. I hope she likes Rose. I hope she appreciates it.
Couple one.
Science says Will's perfect match is Kay from Essex.
Hi, Sia. How you doing?
Good to see you.
What's your name?
I'm Kay.
Oh, you're Rose.
Thank you.
Not bad.
That's a really charming little match there, isn't it?
I'm sorry. I can't really remember a great deal. It went past so fast. I think she liked my rose, which is good. It went down well.
He seems like a good-looking boy. Got me a rose, which is really sweet.
Oh, yeah, can you tell?
Do I fancy him? Maybe.
I can't believe we went first.
I know, honestly, in my heart, it was racist. She's not the normal type of girl that I'd go for. But then I'm gonna, you know, have an open mind and see how it goes.
I don't know his personality yet, so That's a big thing, so I'm looking forward to finding out what he's like.
Will and Kay now have time to chat before they decide if they want to see each other again. Back in the matchmaking room, new couples are being created thick and fast.
How you feeling? You're right.
It's the first step in this year-long experiment. And while some couples look less than happy with their match...
This is terrible, look.
That's not going to work.
I don't know what to say. Not quite what I was expecting, though.
Others seem to hit it off immediately.
Wow. So they saw each other and immediately hugged, and they got a standing ovation. It's a really good atmosphere here today. Everyone's kind of rooting for the couples.
What's your name?
Josie.
She's lovely. She's a really nice girl. Initially, everything's really cool.
I'm definitely looking forward to getting to know him a bit better. Then, yeah, maybe we'll take it further.
Milky.
Okay.
Meanwhile, our first couple, Will and Kay, have been discovering they have a lot in common.
Really? Wow.
Oh, no.
Oh, my God.
How close do we live to each
Very
other?
Very close. We're literally about, I'd say, less than half a mile. Oh, my God. Kay is a nice girl, and we have quite similar interests, so obviously the whole science behind of it does make sense.
Really friendly, chatty guy, which is good. We've got, creepily, quite a lot in common. I have no idea who fancies me or not. We'll have to wait and see, I guess.
I wouldn't say I fancied her yet. One thing that's clouding my judgment at the moment is that I've seen another girl sitting quite close to our table that I do find attractive and probably is more my normal type. But then she's matched with someone else, so I can't obviously go and talk to her.
And Will's not the only one getting distracted by the ladies.
Stranger, yeah.
Checking out another girl.
Thanks for that.
If the boys don't focus on the girl they've been paired with, they'll never find out why they've been matched. Let's hope the next guy looking for love gives science a chance.
A bit nervous, but expected, optimistic. Like I said, not going to lie, if she's not very good looking, I would be pretty disappointed as well.
22-year-old Rogan is a model and a club promoter. He's young, but keen to settle down.
I have been single for 2 years now. I have kind of been looking for love. I kind of got fed up with just seeing girls and just kind of one-night stands and things like that, so decided I want to look for something a bit more serious.
When Rogan's not pumping iron, he's out on the town.
He's a bit of a party boy, so I think what he needs is a girl that can match him and can keep up with him on the social side of it. That might slow him down a bit.
I think there may be a perfect person out there for me. I haven't found them yet, but, yeah, I'm willing to keep looking and trying.
Both scoring high on sociability, Rogan's been paired with 29-year-old Natalie, a shop manager from Guildford.
These two look...
Yeah, good.
..happy with the fact that they've been matched.
Yeah.
And the fact that Natalie's 7 years older doesn't seem to matter.
He is a hottie,
true, yeah.
You know. I'm kind of hoping that he finds me a little bit attractive, and a little bit will be fine.
A little bit, yeah.
Hello. Help
me out. Yeah, no, worth the wait, definitely.
We'll see.
We'll see.
As the day continues, new couples are created by the minute.
What's your name, Sol?
Ruth.
Sam. Yeah.
And many of the guys are out to impress. From the smoothest of operators.
Hello.
Hello.
Yeah, he's really good looking. Good body.
To some real-life Romeos.
He seems really friendly, really charming. He bought me some flowers. I mean, what more can a girl ask for?
I bet you a cocktail.
Let's hope our next girl searching for a soulmate is happy with her match.
My name is Danny. I'm 21 and I live in North London. I definitely believe in love, 100%. I just haven't been successful in picking the right person. It's quite depressing, actually.
I wouldn't say that she's necessarily unlucky in love. She'll always sort of find something that be like, oh no, maybe it isn't right because of this, because she doesn't want to get let down.
I don't think I found my perfect match because I don't think many guys can like keep up with me. Like, I'm quite wild. I go out looking quite classy and not, I don't go out with these little skirts or anything like that. Do I look like Camel? My perfect guy, who'd have like a cheeky tan. I love a bit of tan going on. Like, there's nothing worse than someone being quite pale.
He's got a cheeky tan. He told me he's just had a sunburn.
I think the science can find me the perfect partner because they're scientists, right? They can find out anything. Like, this could be the turning point in my love life. I hope so. Like, I'm quite excited about it.
I'm sexy and I know it.
Danny's match is club promoter Ellis from Kent.
Hiya. You got honey?
Hiya. What do you think?
I like it. They may just work.
Bit of fake tan on the go?
No, something, that's it.
He is everything I fancy. As soon as I see him, I said fake tan. How old are you, babe?
19.
Oh, you look older than that.
Yeah, just good laugh, really. And she's good looking, so. Yeah, big package, so it's all good.
Oh, science is bang on, but boy, I'm loving him. He's up to scratch big time.
Sexy and I know it.
I've got this thing about hygiene, like guys with dirty fingernails or anything like that. Let's see yours.
Oh, no.
No, yours are sweet as. He's definitely tickling my fancy all day long.
Danny's like the female version of me. The same likes, same dislikes.
You better take my number.
I'm going to call you Danny True Love.
Yeah, that'd be nice.
It looks like Danny's found the man she's been looking for. But will our next guy enjoy as much success?
I'm Andrew Cove. I'm from Coventry. Just looking for a bit of love, really.
22-year-old Andy is a personal trainer and fitness fanatic. He might look the hard man, but inside, he's a real softie.
I'd consider myself a bit of a romantic. I believe that you can just fall for someone and you could be with people forever. That my grandma and granddad met, they seen each other at a dance. Fell in love. My granddad asked my grandma to dance with her and they fell in love and stayed together for the rest of their lives. I haven't found my perfect partner yet because I think I've got need time to mature and stuff, and I've not met the right girl that has made me want to mature. If the science does work, then I don't know where it'll lead. I'll just let love blossom.
Both scoring high on loyalty, Andy has been paired with Kirsty, a student from Birmingham.
This is a good one.
This is a good one.
Very strong.
He's happy, she's happy.
Yeah.
Totally staying together.
Absolutely stunning girl. When I first saw her, I'll give her a bit of a twirl on the stage. I got a few laughs.
When I saw him, I was quite pleasantly surprised, actually. He seems like a really nice guy. He's really funny. Oh, my God.
She's really funny, bubbly, everything I was looking for, really. So looks like it's been a pretty good match.
After a day of solid matchmaking, our epic launch event is coming to an end. Hundreds of single people put their faith in a scientific formula. And as the day draws to a close, a final few promising pairings are made.
Hello, beautiful.
Hello.
You look incredible. Ooh, got a piggyback?
Yeah, I love a piggyback.
Oh, my God. There's our marriage. There's our marriage.
Hundreds of introductions have been made. And this extraordinary year-long experiment is well and truly up and running.
So, it's up to the couples now.
Absolutely, you know, our job is virtually done. And now it's up to them, but I mean, we work hard to make their life easier and their journey more enjoyable and successful. So hopefully, you know, it will work.
There's something now fantastic for us, which is we're going to sit back, we're going to watch the experiment take place, and we're going to observe these people, hopefully, in some cases, going through the motions of falling in love, and indeed falling out of love.
When I see you, I thought, oh, my God, like, actual science is real. Like, you're nearly as pretty as me.
Yeah, I'll say we're going to see each other again.
Would you?
Oh, thanks. We're probably not.
First date went pretty well. Quite compatible.
No, it went well. The first date went well. It's good.
I think we're going to see each other again.
Yes.
We've swapped numbers and Faisal's asked me out for dinner.
Just one dinner and then after that, nothing else. Joke.
Yeah, I want to take her home now, but she's not that kind of girl.
He actually has suggested this. No is the answer to that one. We're going to do this properly. There we go, that's it. We've got lipstick on him now.
Oh, yep. Yeah.
There it is.
It's been 2 weeks since the launch of the experiment. Tonight, Natalie is getting ready for a date with Rogan.
I'm less nervous now. I'm actually getting quite excited again, which is a nice feeling, because I hate being nervous. I don't know whether to give him a kiss on the cheek or just to hug him or...
29-year-old shop manager Natalie has been single for the last 4 years.
I believe that there is the perfect match out there for me. It's just taken me a very long time to find that person or for that person to come and find me.
She's not short of admirers, but Natalie hasn't found the one.
I'm not sure what it is, you know. Her relationships have been very short-term lately. When she lets her hair down, she goes a bit wild, maybe a bit too wild, but, you know, maybe that makes people go, oof.
My last proper boyfriend, he was younger than me. That didn't work out because he thought I wanted to obviously do the whole let's get married kind of thing, and he wasn't ready for that. I didn't want that, but he just thought that because I was older. I've also seen guys who are 10 years older than me. It was weird because they didn't know what they wanted. I want to live life and enjoy it, and just hopefully someone can share that with me and we'll just go on the journey together. Simple. That's all I want.
Natalie's been invited to Rogan's place. A 2-hour drive away, she's been offered a bed for the night. But Natalie's determined to take things slow.
My pyjamas and a proper top. Rogan may think that something's going to come out of staying at his house, but I know that that is not going to happen. There's no skin going to be shown. No. If it's all about sex for him, wrong person, I'm afraid. He needs to find somebody else because I'm not that person.
Having suffered heartbreak in the past, Natalie's hoping Rogan will be different.
We are in Rogan land. We are near his home. And I've suddenly started to feel really, 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 really nervous. Right, that's it.
Hello.
You're right. Hello, how are you?
Okay.
Are you good?
Yeah, I'm good. How are you?
Nice to see you.
You too. Do you want to say that?
Oh, thanks.
You're welcome.
Rogan's got some people he'd like Natalie to meet.
Hi.
His mum and dad.
I'm Natalie. Nice to meet you both. How are you? You all right?
Yeah,
not too bad, thank you. Not too bad.
It's a long journey.
A couple of hours, but it was fine. Not too bad.
The meeting with her is just that they obviously seem really, really, really lovely. That was just really weird. I felt a bit awkward. So now I just wanted to, I don't know. I just hope they don't think I'm odd.
Rogan's taking the sofa tonight so Natalie can have his room.
I did a little bit of tidying for the first time in a long time.
Oh, really?
Especially.
No, like, naked photos of girls, no porn anywhere?
Well,
to, like, come across it.
I hid it all, so you're all right.
Right.
But yeah, and I'll just be sleeping downstairs, probably.
Definitely.
Natalie and Rogan escape the watchful eye of Mum and Dad.
Cheers. It's their first date.
First date.
It's their first chance to really get to know each other.
Right, I'm going in with the fingers.
I just want to tuck into the ribs, but...
Do it!
Stuff's going to get messy.
Just take it. First date so far is actually going really well. Well, I think it is, anyway. We're just starting to get a bit more comfortable with each other now. Just looked at me and licked your lips.
I was licking some sweet chilli off my lip. I didn't know you were going to look up at the same time. Yeah, it's going good. Getting on really well.
had some nice drinks, nice food, getting a bit of banter going with Natalie, which is always good. Send
me some kind of... The attraction's there, but Natalie wants to know if the age gap is an issue.
So the fact that I'm pushing on 30,
yeah,
that doesn't bother you at all in the slightest?
Well, it doesn't bother me, ma'am.
That's totally the opposite of what I thought. I convinced myself that you weren't looking for a relationship, that
why are you here?
You were some player.
Why are you here then?
Because I wanted to find out for myself.
Okay, good.
It could have gone either way, couldn't it?
Well, hopefully you found out now, because I'm not some sort of player. I'm just looking for a nice girl.
Genuinely?
Genuinely. So, yeah. Serious questions got, like, a bit deep for me for a first date. She seems to think I'm only after one thing, apparently, which isn't the case at all. I really like her, so we'll just see. Gotta try and convince her otherwise.
I did get a bit deep in the conversation, but to be fair, I did have a few concerns, and obviously he was able to answer them.
Thank you.
Yeah, possibly exciting times to come for Natalie and Rogan, perhaps, maybe, hopefully.
With Mum and Dad asleep upstairs, Natalie and Rogan take the opportunity to have one last nightcap.
OK, Natalie, we're back to my house after we went for a nice date.
Yes.
How are you feeling?
Well, I really fancy Rogan. I'm not going to lie.
That's a given.
I've had more rosé. He's had more... vodka.
Yeah.
And I'm starting to feel the effects of it. But remember what I said. I am not sleeping with Rogan on the first date.
It's the morning after the night before. And Rogan's not on the sofa.
Get in the shower.
I'm not gonna lie, I don't know really kind of the extent of what happened. We came back here, had some more drinks. Had a bit of a chat. Perhaps something more happened. Don't know.
Some wine left if you want.
Shut up.
Bedroom plans might have gone out the window. Yeah, we ended up sharing a bed. Thank.
Worried about what Rogan's thinking, Natalie wants to clear the air.
In all honesty, obviously I didn't want that, like, didn't want that to happen.
Yeah.
But I think whatever was going on, we were quite comfortable with each other.
Yeah.
So, you know, you sleeping in the same bed as me, is whatever, maybe it felt quite natural, so it's not a problem.
Yeah.
But I just hope that your perception of me hasn't changed, like I'm that girl, because, you know, I'd like to think that that's not the sort of be all and end all kind of thing.
Yeah,
so definitely. As long as you don't think I'm that, you know, some kind of floozy.
I know you're not like that.
There you go. So it's cool.
Mm-hmm.
That's fine. And nothing's changed.
Yeah.
So that's awesome.
Yeah.
Wicked.
Good.
Good.
Before saying their goodbyes, Rogan's treating Natalie to a slap-up breakfast.
To the sandwich van.
Served up at his mum and dad's food van.
It's going to be quite peculiar, especially because they're going to obviously ask us how it went last night. But I'm not going to, like, divulge details that they really don't need to know, because I don't want them to think that I corrupted their son. How are you? You all right?
Yeah, good, thanks.
Fine, thank you.
Good time, Russell.
It was lovely.
Yeah,
thank
it was
you.
Great. Thanks.
Brown sandwich.
That's
yeah,
all.
It's me. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
She seems a really sweet girl.
Yeah, it's very difficult when you've only just met her, but she seems lovely, very natural, and good sense of humour.
She'd have to have a good sense of humour, really. To be going out of a robot.
It's very nice.
So, when you come, you're obviously going to come down to me next time.
Yeah, I'm working every night next week. First date with Natalie overall went really well. We had a laugh. Good banter, just felt really comfortable. Yeah, it felt like we've been seeing each other for a long time, so yeah, it was cool.
So my first date with Rogan has gone really well. Yeah, I really like him, and his mum and dad seem really nice as well, and hopefully I've made a good impression on them. We're gonna meet up, I think, in like a couple of weeks' time. I kind of wish it was a bit sooner, but that's fine, I can wait.
Of the experiment, Andy from Nuneaton was matched with Kirsty from Stourport. And it looked like the experts had paired them well.
Yeah, that's a good match. That is a good match. When I saw him, I was quite pleasantly surprised, actually. He seems like a really nice guy. He's really funny.
Looked into your eyes and thought, beautiful. Yeah, I'd say we're going to see each other again.
Would you?
Oh, thanks. We're probably not.
A few weeks later, and Kirsty and Andy's relationship has been moving forward at lightning speed. They've seen each other non-stop and have racked up a whopping £120 of phone bill each.
Since we've been matched, it's actually been moving quite fast. We've been speaking loads. I think we spoke every day.
22-year-old student Kirsty has been out of luck when it comes to finding love.
I do believe in love. I like the idea of it, but I haven't found it yet, so maybe it'll just hit me.
The boys on campus have failed to make the grade.
In previous relationships, I sort of feel like I wasn't treated the way I should be treated.
Student nights out have been non-stop fun for Kirsty, but they're not helping her find a man.
After a drink, I think I'm really annoying, and if a guy meets me and I've had a drink, I think he would be put off straight away.
Love! I want to find love! I want to find someone that I love!
Today, Kirsty's booked a session at an outdoor activity centre, and despite it being early days, she's invited her parents along to meet Andy, hoping for their seal of approval.
What's the situation you've told your mum and dad, like, if you said we're acquaintances or...?
No, I said that, seeing a guy.
Some guy?
Yeah.
He's all right. He's average.
No, I said that I like you, no. But I haven't said that we're going out or anything. I'm really nervous about meeting my parents. I think because I like them a lot, I'm scared if they'll judge them or not.
I've heard the parents are really nice people, so I'm not worried about that sort of thing, because I get on with most people anyway.
Turns out, Andy's not just meeting mum and dad.
We've just got here. Where are you? Oh, there. Grand and granddad are here as well.
Oh, my God.
Wow. No pressure on Andy.
How's it going?
What's Andy, Kirsty? What's
happening? It's Andy. I'm right. It's my dad.
How you going? Pleased to meet you. You're all right.
It's my nan.
Hello.
Granny Bean.
Nice to meet you.
It's my mum.
You're all right.
It's my granddad. All right.
Awesome. Come round.
Yeah.
I just met the parents. They're really nice. Didn't need to be nervous, really. Say hello and stuff. So, yeah, it's fine.
Chucky! Yeah. I was a bit nervous when Andy meeting my parents, but I feel fine like now that I spoke. He's like really like natural with him, fine.
So are either of you scared of heights at all?
Yeah.
That's the worst bit, I think. I'm running! So cocky. And me, like, trembling. My parents are following us, like, the whole thing, taking photos and videos. It looks really easy, but it's not.
It's hard.
Especially when you're not
when you can't look down.
I think he seems a really nice guy, natural, caring, catches her when she's jumping off the platforms.
Seems to be all right, yeah. 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 You seem fine.
It's early days, but Kirsty and Andy do seem to have something.
She's an amazing girl. Never met anyone like her. I hope she'll say the same about me.
He could be a keeper. He's got potential. Yeah, he's got potential to be a keeper.
Something special there. Definitely.
It's been a month since Kirsty and Andy met at the launch of the experiment, and their relationship continues to move at pace. Andy's just moved into his own flat, partly to be closer to Kirsty.
So this is me, my new flat. So, yeah, gonna see how I get on. Some opportunities come up, so I thought I'd take them. Kirsty was a little part of that.
Although she likes him a lot, Kirsty's wondering whether they should slow things down.
I sometimes feel that Andrew's a bit, not keen, but he's the one always talking about, like, where it's going, where are we and stuff, which I like, because I wouldn't ever, like, say anything like that, but it just scares me a little bit. I haven't been in a relationship for, like, a year and a half.
But ever the romantic, Andy's planned a three-course meal at his new flat.
I do feel like I'm a bit of a romantic. I think it's just a bit dead and buried nowadays, and I think if you show a bit of romance to someone, it goes a long way. It's just a little effort that makes a girl go, "Oh."
He's even penned her a poem.
Bit of a funny story, how I first met you. Walked across the stage, eyes beautifully blue, but what I've learned and what I appreciate late at night is how you've shown me the way of what perfect looks like.
But will Andy's efforts actually scare Kirsty off?
A bit nervous, not going in. Don't know why. Hello.
How are you?
Surprise!
I've got all the starter out already.
Oh! Oh, I need a candle! Is this naan bread?
Yeah.
Do you have naan bread and hummus? Are you meant to have pita bread and hummus? It's
like... You did smell what? We're on the start of
our... curry, was it green?
Two courses left, yet.
The presentation was really nice. Got all the cutlery out. All, like, posh. Thank you! £3! He puts, like, loads of effort into things. It's really sweet. That's, like, a thing with, like, my exes. I didn't, like... do, like, special, random, like, things.
Here's the main.
It's like a restaurant.
Of course it is.
But I don't think microwave rice in a restaurant.
Am I doing good?
Yeah. I'm a bit scared to, like, take, like, make it really, like, committed, like, be girlfriend and boyfriend, and it's really scary for me.
So what will Kirsty make of Andy's poem?
Oh, you're so cute. The poem makes me feel like I do really like him. I've got to stop myself from liking him too much too soon. So, being a bit breezy about it. Bye.
At the launch of this ambitious relationship experiment, hundreds of people met their scientific match on stage.
Hiya!
How are you doing? You alright?
Yeah, yeah.
Lovely to meet you.
But in the following days, many decided they were better off single. Will and Kay were the first match to be made.
He seems like a good-looking boy. Got me a rose, which is really sweet.
And the first couple to drop out of the experiment.
I've seen another girl sitting quite close to our table. I do find attractive.
We both took each other's numbers, but I don't think either of us had the intention of really talking to each other afterwards.
Danny and Ellis were delighted with each other on the day.
Hiya. Danny's like the female version of me.
He's definitely tickling my fancy all day long.
Which makes it all the more surprising Ellis never called her. When Faisal met Josie, they agreed to go on a date.
I think we're going to see each other again.
Yeah. My first thoughts when I saw Josie were hips and legs and bum.
They arranged to meet for dinner, but Josie started having doubts.
I'm just dreading the conversation tonight because I don't think we're going to have anything to talk about.
And at the very last moment, she ditched the date altogether.
I don't think I'm going to go. I just don't think I can put myself through it.
Yeah, I got stood up. I'm not hurt, pissed.
In Guildford, it's been weeks since Natalie shared a bed with Rogan, and she hasn't heard from him since.
I've been a bit crappy, because I guess I was kind of expecting to hear from him, I guess. It kind of feels like he's not actually that interested.
She's hoping her older brother, Robert, can offer some sound advice.
Do you want anything else, Nats?
No, thanks.
So what's this guy's name?
He's called Rogan.
Uh-huh.
And he's 22.
He's 22? OK. All right.
But he's cool.
OK, so when you have met up...
The once.
What was it like? How was the, you know, was it
was it was good. Was no, it was fun. I thought we got on really well.
Uh-huh. And so after the next day, who contacted you? So you said he contacted you?
No, I contacted him.
Right, okay. And how did that conversation go?
It was a text message. I didn't hear from him for a while.
Right, okay. I'm not getting good vibes about it, to be honest. I think any brother would probably...